It's definitely a little bit worse. It leverages the same core exploit as WannaCry, but what we find is that the ability to actually take over more of the system is more complex, more sophisticated, and it also has a bit more logic built into the core components.
So this is called Petya. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, Petya.
When you say it's got more logic built in, that implies what? The significance of that means?
Yeah, I would say there's two big things that are different. The first thing is that WannaCry leverages a specific exploit. It's a weakness in the environment, so it exploits a vulnerability. This one leverages the same one.
The same vulnerability?
The same vulnerability in Windows.
Which is what exactly?
So Windows has this way to communicate between servers and devices called SMB, server message block. And that's been known vulnerable. It was part of the NSA, leak that came out when the attack methods were stolen. It's a known vulnerability. Microsoft patched that vulnerability for most of its systems in March. But what you find, and this is evidence of, is systems all over the world are still vulnerable
to this particular exploit. Because they haven't downloaded the patch?
They haven't done it. And, you know, this calls out one of the core things is that a big part of the vulnerability that we find all over the world is the fact that lots of them are known. There's lots of known things that we can do something about, and what you find is that we have not found the mechanisms or the urgency to actually address those issues.
Now, what I've heard is that even if you think you've downloaded this patch at your company, you think everything's complete, if there is one computer that hasn't been patched, that is the weakness in the system, and that's the way in. Is that true?
Well, it absolutely is true. It's the weakness. What I would say is that most of the maturity around IT practices and around cybersecurity are just weak today. And so you have a divergence between the IT teams and the cybersecurity teams. And the way to think about this is a soft underbelly. We have decades of a lack of maintenance of our core technology infrastructure. And lots of companies are rushing to fix it right now, but they're still developing the systems and the process to do that.
So that means if you have one person with a mobile phone that is connected back into the system that didn't download the patch, that didn't get the message on this, that your entire system is still vulnerable, even if you think you've taken off.
Well, not the entire system. So again, the degrees matter here. Okay. Is that the core thing is that if you have one system that's compromised, it's one system. What you find with most of these organizations is one device was compromised and it spread throughout the environment because it actually found the other vulnerable systems within the environment.
The fact worm works its way in and then goes from there.
It works its way in and then it actually spreads.
The fact they're demanding to be paid in Bitcoin. When the ransomware screen comes up, it says you got to pay us in Bitcoin. Is that somebody, is the incentive here because they want Bitcoin to be a more usable currency and more extensive, or is it because of the nature of Bitcoin that it's easier to get paid and nobody can track them?
Well, it's the nature of Bitcoin, absolutely. I mean, for those that actually are going to do any of these types of attacks, and I would argue the entire black market around cybersecurity attacks leverages financial systems that have low transparency, low regulation, of which Bitcoin is a good example.
Can I ask